Hello friends, welcome to the channel Create Your Wealth. Before I begin today's topic, I would like to let you know that we are conducting a free webinar on basics of stock market. You can register for the same at the link given below. It's on 8th July at 4 p.m. IST. So we continue to understand the management evaluation. We understood about the promoter stakeholder, institutional investors like FII, DII, what is the impact of pledging of shares on the retail investors? The next part is how do I evaluate management is by looking at dividend history and the tax rate. The dividend and the tax related expenses are the real cash outgo. An accountant cannot alter those figures. Dividend is nothing but the sharing of the partial profit with the shareholders. As a shareholder, you are entitled to receive dividends as per your ownership. Either the company can reinvest the entire profit into the business or it can distribute the portion of the profit to the shareholder as dividends. Company needs to pay dividend distribution tax before offering the dividends to the shareholder. It is almost impossible to alter the dividend figures because the shareholders ultimately receive the dividend in their hand. Companies, those are consistently paying dividends over the last 10 to 20 years, must have a sound base. If the dividend figures are increasing at least over the last 5 years, then we can assume that the company is a real growth track. High dividend payout is another symbol of a shareholder-friendly management. However, don't consider dividend payout number in isolation. A capital intensive business that requires high investment can opt out to pay dividends to maintain growth. Higher dividend payout ratio with increasing dividend rates confirm that the shareholders' friendliness of management. Indian corporate tax rate stands at 33% net profit. So ideally, companies should report tax rates anywhere between 30 to 35%. If this is not the case, then you need to be digging deeper or investigating. Many companies receive tax incentives for manufacturing particular range of products or for operating in a particular zone. However, those tax incentives cannot last forever. Over the last 5 to 6 years, we can find out that the company was reporting tax rate less than 30% on an average of the net profit. Then we need to look into it with a seriousness. The next point of management evaluation is ROE, return on equity. There is a separate video to explain how ROE is calculated. Here I am explaining about how ROE can help us to evaluate the management. This is a very powerful ratio. It can even throw lights on the management quality and whether the companies are manipulating their accounts or not. High and consistent ROE is an indication of strong management. Manipulating account means that you have either overstated the asset portion in the balance sheet or inflated the expense side in the income statement. The beauty is any such action will automatically lower the ROE. Suppose you have overstated the profit. So you will definitely have to inflate the revenue numbers, that is nothing but the sales number, and understate the expense numbers. Now your fictitious profit should be stored in the asset portion of the balance sheet. By doing so, you are lowering the ROE, return on equity. So companies that are manipulating those books can't report high return on equity consistently. So always consider the last 5 years average ROE. If this figure remains more or less than 12%, then you should, if it goes below 12%, then you need to be cautious. Stay away from such stock. There are thousands of stocks in the market. Better to go with a stock that has higher return on equity. The last 5 years average return on equity should be greater than 20%. This indicates the company is unlikely to manipulate their accounts. You can keep that 20% as a threshold. Personally, I never invest in a stock that has a return on equity less than 20%. It not only offers immense upside potential, but also protects my downside risk. The conclusion is that A combination of a great management with a great business always results in a multi-bagger return for the stock. One of the most prominent examples of this combination is Infosys. The other example like Tata Consultancy Services, HDFC Bank, ITC, etc. Figuring such stock at an early stage is like finding a gold mine. There are many examples of great management with bad business like Satyam and Kingfisher, Deccan Chronicle, where we found that the shares were trading at a very good price but later on had given very bad returns or no returns to the investors. Their wealth had deteriorated. United Spirits is an example of a great business with a bad management. Those kind of stocks will offer moderate returns. The underlying business is so strong that virtually the stock price can't be affected by other factors. Few airline stocks like Kingfisher Airlines are an example of bad business with bad management. Such stocks are a classic example of wealth destroyers. So we conclude this chapter that understanding the management and evaluating them on these parameters can help us understand whether we should go ahead and invest our hard-earned money in this stock or not. Thank you for your support.